just going to show you how by using different parts of this. Different parts of this taper. For tapered bends, the top here. Wider bends down here. And again, this is cut on a wedge opposite to this. And this is why it's the only way it'll bend at 90 degrees straight, but off angle, like going downhill. Let's see. It's just a matter of moving it around, getting it around the bend. Now, I'm deliberately pushing up here to keep this straight at all times, at 90 degrees to the horizontal. You're gonna burn some, get some surface burns there. Really nothing too deep. I don't generally run it this hot, but this piece of wood I had to. Really not normal. That's what the back was made out of. For tighter. Tapered water down there. I've been using this for close to 19 years. Piece of tin is probably, it's quite flexible. It's never cracked. Must be full of lead. More lead than tin, you know. Old cookie jar. Cookie can from way back. Anyways, I use this for the tighter bends. With this, you can put this on around here like this. There you go. See that? I can push on this as hard as I want. As long as I got my finger here clamping this, I can push now far greater pressure and can really control how much is being applied to the actual wood. How much I'm releasing here. You sort of have to roll with it. Roll with it. All I'm saying is here is that the only reason I'm using this is that it's to prove a point that no stainer never used a mold. You bent every side by hand quite easily. A tube like this could fit in, stick it under the fireplace. Would be hot enough. And I don't think they didn't have good metal back then. Anyways, I just lucked out by finding this piece out. Found it the day I needed it. First side I bent, I needed something to bend it with, and I found this out in the field that day. The perfect thing. Stuck it through a brick. The brick takes away some of the heat. Probably enough to, if this doesn't get red hot. And I can just control the flame if I want to control the temperature of the pole. So, now when I have my piece here, then I just will start to place it on here and bend it now to fit this edge. Let's see the parts that need to be bent. these over a bit more. I have a part of that these pretty well. To the shape. It's just making, it's getting perpendicular after, it's gonna be difficult. So this one right there, so just by checking, you can see where the bend has to be. Maybe I don't need this right now. I'm doing this dry, this last bend here. A little more like, more or less anneal the wood. Make it quite sideways like this, you just get a different line of heat. I need to stretch that over a bit. Wet this one again right there in the center. Just needed to get this middle part here wet. Get this in one shot. Okay, well, you get the idea. It's going. Trying to continue and do a little shaping on this one there now.
And I'll come back. Thank you.